Subscribe to our YouTube channel, Shorthand Dictation Legal Matters. But never forget to hit on like icon and share with your friends. Thank you. Ready, start. The honorable member who has just spoken has dealt with certain wider questions which appear to me to go beyond the scope of the present bill, which is a short bill before the House. The House will remember that when this commission was appointed, they were entrusted with two tasks. One was to examine the whole income tax procedure and suggest ways and means to avoid or prevent evasion in future. Secondly, they were to examine specific cases which were referred to them. What the honorable member has been saying really refers to the first part, that is the wider question. As has been stated, I believe, in the statement of objects and reasons we have received from the Income Tax Investigation Commission recommendations on this wider issue, and they will no doubt come up before the House in the form of a measure, and the House will then have full opportunities of considering them, adding to them or altering them so that we might evolve a proper procedure. The sole question before the House now is what to do with the inquiry part of the Commission's work with regard to certain cases that were referred to them. Now I would beg the House to remember that this is not a roving inquiry. This inquiry has been confined to a certain number of specific cases referred to them up to a certain date. No further case can come up before them. Apart from that, a fair number of all the cases that have been referred to them has been disposed of, and a large number still remains, and this bill is limited to those particular cases and none other. It does not affect the larger issue, and obviously the larger issue cannot be considered in the form of amendments to this particular bill, which is meant to give an opportunity to the Commission of Inquiry to complete its task in those specific cases which have been entrusted to it. This matter would normally, of course, have been dealt with by my honorable colleague, the Finance Minister. Unfortunately, he is not here, but I should like to inform the House that next only to the Finance Minister, I have taken a great deal of interest in the work of this Commission, more perhaps than any other of my colleagues. Of course, the Finance Minister will be better able to deal with it. I have also been fairly closely connected with the matter in the sense that I have attached great importance to this work, and I have occasionally had talks with the members of the Commission to find out how they were getting on. May I say that the criticism that has been made, I think, yesterday by an honorable member about the rather sorry result of their labors appears to me totally unjustified. I feel their labors have resulted in very substantial and very good results. They have labored under great difficulties, and in spite of that, they have proceeded calmly and steadily with their work in the highest judicial traditions, and the House will remember that the chairman of this commission is one of our most eminent and respected judges of India. We attached great importance to the fact that a commission of this kind must have men of the highest ability and integrity, and we were fortunate in finding such a man in Mr. Varadachari. Anything entrusted to a judge of that high standing with his lifelong experience of the bench is bound to be carried out in a judicial manner. The House can be sure of that. In fact, possibly if delays have occurred, as they have, partly they are due to the fact that the Commission and the Chairman are anxious to preserve every type of judicial procedure and not to do anything which might even give any suspicion of hurrying through and not giving that opportunity which should be given. If the House could see the decisions that they have given, they are tremendously long, 70, 80 or 100 pages. They have carefully gone through every opportunity and have come to certain decisions. Most of these decisions also, I would like the House to remember, are ultimately by consent. Now, the difficulty in dealing with such matters through, let us say, the Income Tax Department, which is the normal way of dealing with them, has been that they cannot deal with them both judicially and at the same time informally. They have to be formal. Their rules govern them, and the people concerned do not like that particular process. They do not welcome it. They do not go there easily unless they are compelled by law to go there. They do come, at least relatively, with this reluctance to this inquiry commission, because the inquiry commission can deal with them informally, can come to deal with them informally, can come to terms with them, almost any terms that they consider just and proper, which the Income Tax Department cannot easily do always in this manner stop.